Hello all, my name is Sujin George and welcome to this lecture series of surveying. In today's video, we are going to discuss about transition curve. Now, transition curve is a type of a horizontal curve and it is a curve of varying radius. Means the radius, it varies from zero at the tangent point to a specified value just at the junction with the circular curve. This transition curve, it is actually provided on both ends of a circular curve. This is a typical transition curve. Now you can see over here that these are supposed two straights. This is straights AB and this is straight BC. Now in between these two straights, transition curves are provided like this. This is the transition curve and it is provided at both ends of a circular curve. This is the transition curve. Again, one more transition curve will be here, and at the center there will be a circular curve. So according to this, it is a curve of varying radius. It is a curve of varying radius and it is provided on both ends of a circular curve. This is the circular curve and it is provided at both ends of a circular curve. Now, the radius of such a curve varies from zero at the tangent point. Means this is the tangent point. Let us call this tangent point as T1. This is the point of curve. So it varies from zero at the tangent point to a specified value just at the junction with the circular curve. Now this is the junction. This is the junction. Let us call this junction as D. So at this junction, this is the junction where the transition curve finishes and the circular curve starts. So this junction D is that point. So this junction will the radius will have a specified value just at the junction with the circular curve. Means this will be the radius of the circular curve. Okay, please keep in mind that this is the radius of the circular curve and here this radius will be equal to the transition curve. Okay, this radius will be equal to the transition curve at this point D. But as we move away from this, the radius will keep on changing. Okay, the radius will keep on changing and at this point T1, at this tangent point T1, the radius will become 0. Okay, the radius will become 0. Now, where is this tangent, transition curve actually provided? Okay, now these transition curves, they are provided at the at roadways or in railways for the smooth conduction of any type of a vehicle or railways. Now, for example, this is a circular curve. This is a simple circular curve. Okay. Now, if actual vehicles has to pass through this, then a circular curve will be there. This is a straight road. From here, there will be a curve going like this. Okay. Now, if the transition is not provided and if only the curve is in a circular manner, then the vehicles will not be able to move freely. Hence, such a transition curve has to be provided at roadways or railways. Fine. Now, let us discuss the parts. Now, let us discuss the notations of transition curve. Or you can also call it as the notations of the combined curve. Now this is called as a combined curve because this is not only a transition curve. This curve comprises of transition as well as the circular curve. Hence, we can call this as a combined curve. So let us see the notations of the combined curve. Now we know that these two straights, they intersect. The outer angle, this is known as delta. This is the deflection angle delta. We all know this. We have learned this in the simple circular curve topic. So this is the deflection angle. Now, if this is the deflection angle, so this will be the intersection angle I. Okay, this will be the intersection angle I. So I is called as the angle of intersection. Now, let us say that this point is T1 and this point is D. Let us call this as E and this point is T2. This is the point T2. So in a transition curve, these points means the tangent point, they should be tangential to the straights. Okay, this T2 should be tangential to the straights, and also this transition curve should meet the circular curve also tangentially. Okay, it should meet the circular curves also tangentially. Now, suppose this is the center O of the circular curve, and if this is the deflection angle delta, then obviously the central angle will also be equal to delta. This is the total central angle of the circular curve. This is the circular curve. Now here AB is the back tangent. AB is the back tangent, and BC is the forward tangent. BC is the forward tangent. Now here this T1 is known as the first tangent point or the starting point of the curve. So this is the first tangent point TP. And here T2 will be known as the second tangent point. Okay, or it can also be called as the finishing point of the curve, finishing point of the transition curve. Now here this angle, it will be phi, and these two angles will be similar to each other. Okay, in any case, the transition curve will be similar only. Okay, means the length of the transition curve, they will be similar. So if the lengths are similar, so this angle that they make at the center, it will also be similar only. So if this angle is phi, this angle should also be phi, and this phi, it is known as the spiral angle. This phi is called as the spiral angle. Now there will be a central angle. Suppose this is delta C, and this delta C is called as the central angle. So this central angle will be equal to, this will be, central angle is delta C, and this delta C will be equal to this total delta minus phi. Minus phi, we will get this central angle delta C. So this will be delta minus phi, that is 2 phi. So this central angle delta C is equal to delta minus 2 phi, means this angle. This is called as the central angle. Okay. Now here this T1D, it is the transition curve, and ET2 is also the transition curve. These are the length of the transition curve, and DE, this is the length of the circular curve. Okay. And this length T1, D, E, T2, the total length T1, D, E, T2 is known as the combined curve. It is called as the length of the combined curve. Now here we can see a shift is provided over here. This circular curve, this is also a circular curve. Okay, now when this circular curve changes to the transition curve, now when this D is extended over here and E is extended over here, so a portion is provided over here which is called as the shift. Okay, this portion, it is known as the shift of the curve. Okay, hence this angle, this length is known as the shift. Let us call, let us say that this is T1 dash and this is D1 and this is T2 dash and this is E1. Okay, so this T1 dash D1 will be equal to this T2 dash E1. That is equal to the shift of the curve. We'll see what the shift is, but before, we have to discuss about the notations of the combined curve. So I hope you understood all the notations of the combined curve. Now we'll see what a super elevation is. Super elevation or cant. Super elevation or cant. Now let us see what a super elevation is. Now here, if a vehicle is moving on a curved path, this is a vehicle and it is moving on a curved path. So there will be two forces acting on this vehicle, and this force will act through its centroid. Okay, one will be the weight of the vehicle, suppose it is W, and other will be the centrifugal force. Other will be the centrifugal force, and both the forces will pass through the CG of the vehicle. Okay, both the forces will pass through the CG of the, suppose this is the CG of the vehicle. Now the, since the centrifugal force always acts perpendicular to the axis of rotation, its direction is horizontal, acting away from the center of the curve. Okay, suppose this is the center of the curve. So its direction will always act in a horizontal manner away from the center of the curve. Weight of the vehicle will act vertically only. Okay. So suppose this angle is given as theta, and here there will be the resultant R. This is the resultant R. So if this is theta, this angle will also be theta. Okay. Now this centrifugal force, let us call this centrifugal force, is given by the formula W V square upon G into R, where W is the weight of the vehicle, V is the velocity with which the vehicle is moving, that is the speed of the vehicle, G is the acceleration due to gravity. Normally it is given as 9.81 meter per second square, and R, it is the radius of the curve. Okay, R is the radius of the curve. Now here this is the resultant, this is not R, this is not the radius. Okay, but here R is the radius of the curve. Okay, now according to the requirement of an ideal transition curve, this super elevation cant, super elevation or cant, should increase, it should increase uniformly. It should increase uniformly with increase of centrifugal force P. Okay, and that too at a constant rate, at a constant rate. Means the speed of the vehicle is assumed to be constant. Okay, speed of the vehicle, this V, it is assumed to be constant. That is, speed of vehicle is constant. It is assumed to be constant. So, the centrifugal force is proportional to the length of the transition curve. Okay. So, in this case, the centrifugal force P, it will be proportional to the length of the transition curve. Let us call P as the centrifugal force and capital L as the length of the transition curve. Or we know that P is W V square upon G R. Just now we saw this P, centrifugal force, is W V square upon G R. So, this will be proportional to L. This will be proportional to L. And here W, V, G, all three are constant. Weight of the vehicle will be constant only. Acceleration due to gravity will be constant. And we are assuming that this speed of vehicle is also constant. So, this will become 1 by R is proportional to L. 1 by R is proportional to L, or it can be written as L into R is a constant. L into R, it is a constant. Okay, this is the condition of an ideal transition square. This is the condition of an ideal transition square, that length of the transition curve and radius of the curve should be the product, it should be a constant value. Okay, it should be a constant value. So, based on this, let us find out the ideal transition curve. Okay, let us find out the ideal transition curve. Now, if we consider this figure, this T1D is a transition curve. Okay, this T1D, it is a transition curve TC. Okay, total length of the transition curve is given as capital L. Okay, D is the junction point, means it here this point, at this point the transition curve ends and the circular curve begins. Okay, the circular curve, it begins from this point D. Now, this T1A is the back tangent. T1A is the back tangent. This capital R is the radius of this junction. Actually, you can say it is the radius at this junction. This radius will be of the circular curve as well as the transition curve. So, let us call this as the radius of the transition curve, capital R. Now, as we move from here, from D to T1, we said that the radius of curve, it changes from this definite value over here and it moves to 0 at this point T1. Okay, it becomes 0, or it changes its radius till T1. So, the radius is not constant. Okay, the radius of the transition curve, it is not constant. Let us assume a point P on the transition curve, and this P is at a distance of small l from this tangent point T1. This T1 is the tangent point. Okay, so it is at a distance of l from the tangent point, and let us say that this P has, at this point P, the radius of the curve is given as small r. The radius of curve at this point P is small r. Okay, now here at this junction D, one line is made which is perpendicular to this radius. So, obviously this line, it has to be tangential, it has to be tangent to this point D. Okay, and here the angle phi, it will be the spiral angle, or you can call this as the angle between this T1A, and this transition curve or the tangent at point D. Also, one spiral, there is a tangent point here as well. Okay, this is also a tangent point. And the spiral angle made between this tangent point P and this back tangent T1A is given as phi 1. Okay, let us say that this length, the point P, this x is the horizontal distance of point P and y is the vertical distance or the vertical coordinate of the point P. Fine. Also, this alpha is the deflection angle between the chord length T1P and the back tangent. We have seen the deflection angle. Okay, it is between the chord length and the back tangent. Now, according to this requirement, 1 by r is proportional to L. Okay, so according to the fundamental requirement, of a transition curve is that its radius at any point shall vary inversely as the distance from the beginning of the curve. Okay, what it is saying that the radius at any point shall vary inversely as the distance from the beginning of the curve. Means if here the radius is capital R and the length of the transition curve is capital L. So this radius at any point on the transition curve will be inversely proportional to the length. Means the distance from the tangent point till the point. Okay, so we have taken a point P over here and the distance is small L till this point P. So here we can write the radius at P is small r. Okay, so according to this fundamental requirement, we can say that 1 by r is proportional to L. Okay, at any point, suppose here we take a point here and the radius here is r1 and the length is taken as L1. So 1 by r1 will be proportional to L1. Okay, so this 1 by r is proportional to L, or it can be written as 1 by r is equal to m into L, where m is a proportionality constant. Okay, now again, for any curve, we know that this is the spiral angle over here at this point. It is given as phi 1. So for any curve d phi 1 upon dl, it will be equal to 1 by r. Or it can be written as d phi 1 is equal to 1 by r into dl. But from here, 1 by r is equal to ml. So if we substitute this over here, we will get d phi 1 is equal to ml into dl. M into L into dl. Now if we integrate this, we get phi 1 is equal to ml square by 2. This will become ml square by 2 plus c. Phi 1 will be equal to ml square by 2 plus c. Now, when this small l is equal to 0, when this small l is equal to 0 means it is over here. Okay, we started from here. When this l is equal to 0 means with when it is at point t1. When it is at point t1, and if this is at point t1, so obviously this phi 1 will also be equal to 0. Okay, at point t1, l will be 0 and phi 1 will also be 0. So when l is equal to 0, phi 1 is also equal to 0. Therefore, c will also be equal to 0. Okay, if we put these values here, we get c also equal to 0. So we get this as phi 1 is equal to ml square by 2. Means this spiral angle phi 1, it is equal to ml square by 2. Now this is at point P. Okay, this is at point P. So at point D, this is the junction point D. From here, this transition curve ends and circular curve starts. So at point D, this L will be equal to capital L. L will be equal to capital L. And this radius small r will be equal to capital R. Okay, small r, that will be equal to capital R. So if we consider this equation, this will become 1 by capital R is equal to m into capital L. This will become 1 upon capital R is equal to m into L, capital L. Or it can be written as m is equal to 1 upon R L. Okay. And from this equation, we will get the spiral angle as phi 1. We will get the spiral angle as phi 1 is equal to, also you can see here at this point D, this phi 1 will become phi. Okay, phi 1 will become phi. So phi 1 will be equal to phi, and this will become m l square by 2. Okay, phi 1 will become phi, and this equation will become m l square by 2. And if we substitute this value of m in this, we will get it as 1 by r l into l square by 2. Or we can write this as phi is equal to L upon 2R. Phi is equal to L upon 2R, and this value of phi will be in radians. And if we need to convert into degrees, we will get this as L upon 2R multiplied by 180 by pi, and this value will be in degrees. Okay, so this equation is known as the intrinsic equation. Of ideal transition curve. Okay, so this equation, that is spiral angle, phi is called as the spiral angle, as we have seen over here. This is the spiral angle phi of the transition curve. Okay, here also phi, here also phi, because there are two transition curves. So this spiral angle phi, it is given as L upon 2R in radians, or L upon 2R into 180 by pi in degrees. And this equation is known as the intrinsic equation of the ideal transition curve. Fine. So in today's lecture, we learnt about the transition curve, what a transition curve is, what are the notations of the combined curve. Combined curve is transition curve plus circular curve. Also, we saw what super elevation or cant is. We saw the this equation for the centrifugal force, and also this ideal requirement of the centrifugal force, that is 1 by r is proportional to l, that is radius at any point on the transition curve, it is inversely proportional to the length of the transition curve. Or fundamental requirement of a transition curve is that its radius at any point shall vary inversely as the distance from the beginning of the curve. Okay, and then with the help of this, we found out the equation for the spiral angle, and this is called as the intrinsic equation of the ideal transition curve. Thank you so much.